Okay, everybody, and welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. Today we are going to be taking a look at this block here behind me. This is called the Element Constructor. And as you may have guessed, using this block, we can create all of the different elements that are to be found in Minecraft. So let's go ahead and take a look over at the Element Constructor. Now, you can get one of these by going to your inventory, typing Element Constructor, and moving it down there. And if we right-click on the Element Constructor, you will see three different sliders. You can adjust the values of protons, electrons, and neutrons. And in the right combinations, they will produce what's called a stable isotope. And in this case, six of each will produce carbon for us, and we can drag that down there from the output into our inventory. And then we can use these kind of like normal building blocks, really. Of course, the main function of these is to be used in the compound creator, which we will look at in a following video. And on from there, from the compound creator, we can create things using the lab table. And I think we get some pretty interesting recipes and stuff. There's a brewing station that you can use as well. We're going to be going into quite a lot of depth on those in upcoming videos. Now, on a side note, there is a block called a material reducer, which is another way to get the elements. And it kind of works in the opposite way to the element constructor, whereby you put blocks into it and it will reduce them down to their constituent elements that are inside of it, and you can move those into your inventory. Now, those are a couple of the ways that you can get elements. Now, there are, as I said, 118 elements in total, so I highly recommend getting a little book like this, printing it out. You can find these online. It's a list of all the different elements. I shall put the link to the one I use in the description of this video, and inside you will find a big list of all the different elements and how to create them with the correct number of protons, electrons, and neutrons, the atomic symbol and element name, and all those kind of things. Now, let's have a little discussion about some of the ways we can use these with our students in our lessons. Now, if you go onto the Minecraft Education website, you will, and you search in things like physics or chemistry or elements, you will find a few lessons relating to learning about some of the principles of those subjects. Some of the things that I've done and found very useful are word games. So you can give your students a copy of the list of elements, and you can see how many different words they can spell out using the atomic symbol, which are the letters on the side. Also, you could do a collaborative build and get your students to construct, working as a team, the periodic table, so learning about the periodic table as well there. Now, those are just some of the different things you can do. There is an excellent world of chemistry, a world that you can download from the Minecraft website where you can explore these, and it kind of lets you explore a little bit freely. It's not the most structured, it doesn't hold your hand, it's not really a tutorial, but it's very good for those students who are keen to kind of explore how chemistry and physics work in the Minecraft world. Now, as I said before, moving forward, I will be covering compound creators and lab tables and brewing stations. But for now, we're going to finish up there. Please do like and subscribe so that when those videos do come along, you'll see them in your feed. And I will see you next time.